way back in 1994, and amongst this gathering here, we have some participants of that. Even though Dr. Reddy could not come, he has been constantly messaging here. I'm so grateful to you, Dr. Guru Prasad, not only coming here, but also speaking at such a short notice. And like Marshal Nawar brought out, both of you had one thing in common, the Vice Chief and yourself, that enhanced tolerance for failure. I think that's something so very, very important. I'm also grateful to this huge gathering of participants here. I mean, it's, let me be very frank, 27th July, when we had the event on technology infusion and indigenization with the Indian Air Force, a lot of people scared us that if you have two events with the Air Force back to back, where will you get the attendance? Look at it for yourself. I think I'm really grateful to the participants for having come out in such large numbers. It is only reinforcing the fact how keenly the industry is getting into this domain more and more. Allow me to quote some figures. Where has all this led to? If you remember the last time, the BRD had brought out that each one has almost 1,000 vendors with itself. There are 50,000 components of the Air Force that have been indigenized. And the rate of indigenization that we are today talking about is 3,000 per year. There are 50 projects with this great new initiative of the Indian Air Force called the Nodal Technology Center. It has got 50 projects that it is running currently. And as was brought out by the Air Chief last time, that the BRD is maintaining 50-year-old aircrafts, and you've seen the way they have flown during Exercise Garam Shakti. It is a testimonial to what the industry is doing for the Air Force and what the Air Force is doing for the industry. Can we talk of any better synergy than this? And these 50-year-old aircrafts are flying with 95% components indigenized. So I think that's really some great achievement. Let me bring out another point. Only the last week we had over here, as the SIDM, we had organized on behalf of the DRDO, the Technology Development Fund meetings and the GITA. Let me tell you, in the current project that we are looking for partnership, out of the 14 projects, 7 are of the Indian Air Force. So that is the pace at which I think India's defense aviation sector is moving. Allow me to also thank and bring to your notice the kind of speakers that we have. Like, for example, we have all the senior officers from the Air Force, the Deputy Chief of Air Staff, we've got Air Marshal Lambia, we've got Air Officer in Charge Maintenance, Air Marshal Shera, and all the others, Technical Manager Air, the Project Director of AMCAR, Dr. Ghosh, of course, a number of luminaries from the industry, Mr. Ashwini Bhargav from Boeing, and if I may say, what a delight to have Mr. Koslow, the Deputy Director General of Rosoboran Export. I think this is the first, you may please show yourself. Yeah, great. I think this is the first time we are having a speaker of such a stature from the Rosoboran coming to speak to us. Commodore Sujit Samata from Niti Aayog. This is the second time that SIDM has achieved, and we are so proud of it, to get the state industry secretaries. We had done it during the DEF Expo. This time again we have Dr. Rajendra Yadav, Mr. Santosh Yadav, Mr. Krishna Kishore, Mr. Praveen from Tamil Nadu, Uttar Pradesh, Andhra Pradesh and Telangana, respectively. This is just to show how the entire country, that is the federal structure here, and the states are coming together for defense in aerospace.